हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द स्टैटिस्टिक्स क्लास. ये लास्ट सेशन वी डिड टू मेथड्स ऑफ फाइंडिंग द कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट. नाउ इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अगेन द थर्ड मेथड ऑफ फाइंडिंग द कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट. इन दिस केस द मीन शुड बी इन डेसिमल्स. डेसिमल्स मीन्स द मीन इज नॉट अ होल नंबर, इट विल बी विथ the decimal points. In that case, instead of x minus x bar, we will be using x minus a, where a means the assumed mean. Assumed mean means if suppose the mean is 157.83, we will round it off. Round it off means we can take it as either 158 or you can take it as 160. That 158 or 160 is called as a. So u will be x minus a. V can be taken as y minus b, where a and b are the assumed means of x and y, which will be considered as a whole number. Now let us do illustration 9 of your textbook, which is based on this formula. Here we have to find the correlation coefficient between the heights and weights of the students. The height of the students we are taking as x, the weight we are taking as y. Now let us first find the mean and check it whether it is in decimals or it is a whole number. So the first step which we are supposed to do is do the total of x. So when you do the total of x, the value will be 953. Similarly, do the total of y. So when you do the total of y, it will be 344. Now if you see, the number of observations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 observations are there. So let us first find the means. X bar will be equal to sigma x upon n. Now let us calculate this value. This will be 953 divided by 6. So when you divide, you will get it as 158.33. Similarly, find y. Y is sigma y upon n. So this will be 344 divided by 6. When you find this, it will be 57.33. So when you see over here, what is the value? This is in decimals. This is also in decimals. So we have to use the assumed mean method. So 158.33, which we are having, we will round it off and take it as 158. And this value we will be taking as 57. So now let us calculate u and v. Now see, when you are supposed to do the value calculation, u will be equal to x minus a. A means the round off value of mean. So that is 158. Now subtract these values of x and a. A is 158. So 155 minus 158 will be minus 3. 165 minus 158, that will be 7. 158 minus 158 will be 0. 162 minus 158, that will be 4. 153 minus 158, that will be minus 5. 160 minus 158 will be 2. Now do the total of u, that is add these numbers. So when you add these numbers, you will have the value 5. Now v will be y minus the assumed mean. Assumed mean will be 57. Now subtract the values. 53 minus 57, so that is minus 4. 63 minus 57, so that is 6. 56 minus 57 will be minus 1. 60 minus 57, that will be 3. 52 minus 57, that will be 5. 60 minus 57 will be 3. Now do the total of this. So when you do the total, you will be getting 2 over here. Now the next step is multiply u and v. So minus 3 into minus 4 will be 12. 7 6s are 42. 0 into minus 1, 0. 4 3s are 12. Minus 5 into minus 5, that is 25. 2 3s are 6. Now again do the total of this. So when you do the total of uv, you will be getting 97. Now the next step is u square. So square these values. Minus 3 square will be 9. 7 square 49. 0 square 0. 4 square 16. 5 square 25. 2 square is 4. Now again do the total of u square. So when you add these values, you will be getting 103. Now v square. Square these values. Minus 4 square 16. 6 square 36. 1 square 1. 3 square 9. 5 square 25. 3 square is 9. Now do the total of this. So the total will be 96. Now what will be our next step? Just substitute the values and find the answer. So when you substitute the values in the formula, what you will be having? See, R will be equal to N is 6, UV total is 97, minus U total is 5, sigma V total is 2, divided by under root of 6 into u square is 103 minus u total is 5 the whole square into under root of 6 into v square is 96 minus sigma v is 2 the whole square. Now you can solve it out. This will be 582 minus 10 divided by under root of 593 into under root of 3, this will be 572. You can solve this and the answer which you will be getting will be 0.98. Now this 0.98, if you see, this is close to 1. So it is high degree of positive correlation. Now let us solve another question on the same method. Let us do question number 7 of exercise 2.2. Here again we are supposed to find the correlation coefficient between age and blood pressure. Age we are taking as X, blood pressure we are taking as Y. Now what will be our first step? Do the total of X and Y. So when you do the total of X, that is when you add these values, you will get 464. Do the total of Y. So when you add this, you will be getting 1153. So this is sigma X, this is sigma Y. Now let us find the mean. So when you do the calculation for the mean, X bar will be sigma X upon N. So that is 464 divided by the number of observations. Here you are having 8 observations. So when you divide this, you will be getting 58. Similarly, y bar, that is sigma y by n. Sigma y is 1153 divided by 8. So when you solve this, the answer which you will be getting will be 144.125. So what do you see? This is in decimals and this is a whole number. So we can apply this method UV. So here, let us do the calculation now. U will be x minus a. A, we can take it as same, that is 58, because mean is a whole number. So this is x minus 58. That means assumed mean will be 58. So first one, 58 minus 58, this is 0. 55 minus 58, that is minus 3. 65 minus 58, that is 7. 52 minus 58 will be minus 6. 48 minus 58 will be minus 10. 68 minus 58 is plus 10. 62 minus 58, so that is 4. And 56 minus 58 is minus 2. This is the value. Now do the total of U. You will be getting sigma U, and this will be 0 because the deviation is from the exact mean. Now Y minus 144.125 we are having. So we can take it as rounded off value, that is 150. So we will be Y minus 150. It will be easy for us to calculate if we are taking 150. So 130 minus 150 will be minus 20. 150 minus 150 is 0. Again it is 0. 130 minus 150 is minus 20. 140 minus 150 is minus 10. 158 minus 150, that is 8. This 155 minus 150 is 5. And 140 minus 150 is minus 10. Now what is the next step? Do the total. So when you add, you will be getting minus 47. This is sigma V. Now the next step is UV. Multiply these two columns. So 0 into minus 20 is 0. Minus 3 into 0 is 0. 7 into 0 is 0. 6 into 20 is 120. 10 tens are 100. 10 8s are 80, 4 5s are 20, 2 10s are 20. So when you do the total, you will be getting 340. Next step is U square. That is, take the square of these values. So 0 squared 0, minus 3 square 9, 7 square 49, 6 square 36, 10 square 100, 100. 4 square 16, 2 square 4. Now do the total of this. So this will be 314, that is sigma U square. Now V square is, do the total of this values. So 20 square is 400, 0, 0, 400, 100, 64, 25 will be square of 5, and 10 square is 100. Now again do the total. So when you do the total, this will be 1089. So now you are having all the values. Now just to substitute and do the calculation. So when you do the calculation, see, n is 8 into UV total is 340 minus U total is 0 into sigma V is minus 47 divided by under root of 8 into U square is 314 minus sigma U, that is 0 the whole square, into under root of 8 into V square is 1089 minus 47 the whole square, that is sigma V. Now do the calculation. You can solve this out, and the answer which you will be getting will be 0.67. So this is the correlation coefficient between the age and blood pressure. Now students, do two questions as your homework. That is question number 8 of exercise 2.2. And of exercise 2, section F, do question number 1 as your homework. These two questions are based on the method which I have taught you. In the next session, we will continue the same method, but slight difference is there in the calculation that I'll teach you. Thank you.